Hi, fellow lean maniacs. Just a quick video. I've had lots of questions about how do we improve flow in the hidden factory. What's the hidden factory? Well, interestingly enough, you all have one. It's everything between sales and your shop floor order. Using a Kanban board is one of my favorite tools to establish flow in your hidden factory. So stay tuned. I'm going to let my avatar take over and explain how it works.
Think of a Kanban board as a pull system for tasks. Where can we use a Kanban board? Well, typically we use it in an office environment to manage tasks for a team. Why do we use a Kanban board when we can just assign projects and tasks to teams? Well, a funny thing happens when we assign tasks to people. I get stuck on something. Let's say I'm waiting for an answer from someone, or I'm waiting for someone else to do something before I can go back onto this task, or I'm not sure, I don't have the information I need, or I don't understand it. Whatever it is, I'm stuck on a task and I put it aside and I get another task going because I want to keep busy. I don't want to do nothing. So I'll grab another task. Again, I'll work on it for a little while. I'll get stuck on it. This is called a push system. Tasks are piling up all over my desk. I have work everywhere and a lot of it started and nothing's getting completed. Nothing is getting done. There's no flow. Essentially, tasks are not getting completed. They're being shuffled around as we take on even more tasks. Sound familiar? This results in people picking up and putting down tasks over and over and over again and having to refamiliarize themselves with where they were when they left off, which quite often can mean interrupting other people for more information when you're ready to get started on that task that you put aside. This leads to much longer lead times, a lot of frustration, and basically a lot of busy work. The focus is keeping yourself busy while at work, but not on the task at hand. And if I don't want to do something, I just keep picking up the task that I do want to do. Kanban board works well because it's visual. Anyone in proximity can see the status of various tasks, no interruptions needed, or even status review meetings. And it's not hidden in a computer somewhere. It's simple, easy to use, and very powerful. What makes it so powerful is that we limit the amount of work in process allowed in the work in process column. It's probably a little easier if I use a sports analogy. So the soccer players are working independently on their own tasks, and the ball represents a task, and here's what happens. We get stuck, we move off the field, we go get another ball, another task, we start something else, we abandon it. When we get stuck, we go get another one. And before we know it, the soccer field is covered in soccer balls and no one's scoring any goals. Nothing's getting across the finish line. Well, that's more like it. Look how the team's focusing on one task and that soccer ball is flowing across that soccer field right to the goalpost.
Notice how the team is always working on something. But with a Kanban board, we're limiting the number of tasks that they can have as work in process. So they're focusing on specific tasks, and this is establishing flow. Just like we would in your factory, we would reduce your work in process to establish flow, therefore reducing your lead times. Hopefully this video has inspired you to learn more about your hidden factory and Kanban boards. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button to keep it connected to Quantum Lean. Better yet, head on over to our quantumlean.ca website for more tools and training.